HWE Mining, as part of Leighton Contractors Resources Division, entered into an alliance contract with Newmont Tanami to mine gold at Callie in 2003. Callie is one of Australia's most productive underground gold mines. Callie Gold Mine is situated 600 kilometres northwest of the Northern Territory's Alice Springs in the middle of the Tanami Desert, where summer temperatures hover around 36 to 38 degrees Celsius and can reach into the high 40s. The traditional Aboriginal landowners call the area around Callie Gura. They have known about the gold there for a long time, and an important local belief is that of Wawulja, the invincible warrior who travelled with his many wives through Gura, where his wives laid him down and treated the boils that covered his body. These boils seeped into the earth, forming Callie's gold. HWE Mining currently excavates about 2.1 million tonnes of ore per annum to produce about 380,000 ounces of gold. Callie's mine life is expected to extend beyond 2015. Newmont Tanami is putting a lot of effort into drilling to locate new ore bodies. Once an ore body is found, underground diamond drillers take samples to determine more precisely where the ore is. Geologists then generate models to define economical mining shapes. This information is passed on to HWE Mining's mining engineers, who then design the mine stopes, the excavations made to extract the ore. Primary and adjacent secondary stopes are designed, which enables maximum extraction of the ore in a checkerboard fashion. The primary stopes are mined first, and when mining is complete, these are filled with cemented aggregate fill, CAF. The adjacent secondary stopes are then mined, benefiting from the primary support stopes. The ore is then trucked to the surface to be transported to the mills where the gold is extracted and consolidated into gold bars for the Perth Mint to refine. Monitoring the workforce and performance in an underground mine requires much more diligence than surface mining, where operations are visible. Underground mining also presents the challenge of coordinating the movements of trucks from several headings, endpoints of the underground mining access tunnels, to a single mine exit. Additional issues from undertaking underground mining include ventilation, heat buildup, depth of mining. At present, the mine is over 1 kilometre underground and going deeper, and operating a large underground fleet. Currently, there are 15 trucks underground. As Callie is located close to the centre of Australia, employees fly in from all around the country and stay at the project's camp accommodation. The camp amenities include a swimming pool, gymnasium, tennis courts and canteen. There is a Telstra phone connection between the mine and the camp, enabling email and phone communication. And mobile telephone coverage is available around the camp, allowing employees to stay in touch with their families. The total workforce at Callie, including the Newmont Tanami staff, is about 700, and of those, approximately half are direct HWE Mining employees. Approximately 14% of HWE Mining's employees are Indigenous. Callie Project Manager has also discussed options to increase Indigenous employment with the Aboriginal Central Land Council in Alice Springs. Callie's underground miners work a 2-week on, 1-week off roster. There are significant safety risks in underground mining that need to be carefully managed, such as handling explosives. It is how these risks are managed that determines how safe an operation is. The project team is very proactive with regards to safety and has adopted the phrase safe production, because production has little value if safety is not maintained. Accounting for everyone underground is a fundamental safety undertaking at Callie. A tag board is used where employees tag on when they go underground and they tag off when they come up. Explosives are not fired until there is absolute surety that everybody is out of the underground environment. The only person allowed to take a tag off the board is the owner of that tag. Several safety initiatives have been undertaken at Callie. For example, a recent stop day for safety was held. All production was stopped to catch up on the mine's housekeeping activities. For example, spray lines keeping dust levels down in the mine are very difficult to repair when trucks are running, so all the sprays were repaired. The feedback from the workforce on that exercise was extremely positive. Newmont Tanami and HWE Mining share a long and very good relationship. it goes back to when Eltons first had the contract at the Tanami, before Henry Walker and Elton merged to become Henry Walker Elton, the forerunner of HWE Mining. The latest alliance contract has allowed both companies to openly share their resources and expertise to optimise the procurement of equipment and people, and to achieve the best outcomes for the mine.